Hi everybody, David Dilling from Markzware. Today's tip is how to merge multiple InDesign files into one document, for lack of better words. Many of our Q2ID customers, our QuarkXPress to Adobe InDesign plugin customers, are used to, in modern versions of QuarkXPress 9 and 10, to have tabbed individual layouts all within one layout document, one.qxp. And they ask, well, how can we do that in InDesign? Now, Q2ID, as you can see in the video I'll link to and maybe clip into here for a moment, will convert all those multiple layouts in one layout within QuarkXPress. They'll be converted into individual InDesign files. But what people would like is, just like in Quark, those individual files to be all within one file. How can we do that in Adobe InDesign CC or even CS6 or CS5.5, CS5? That's what we're going to show you today, how you can do that. Now, what I'm opening up here is One QuarkXPress document, there's multiple tabs up top. These are called layout tabs. These are all individual layouts within one file. Now, as far as I can see, InDesign doesn't really have that per se. Well, they do, and it's called a book file, and I'm going to show you that, but they don't have this exact feature where you have one file with multiple tabs. What InDesign has, and I'll show you now, which looks similar, is this. So if I open up two of those menus, which I've converted with Q2ID, and you can see in another video, if I open up two of those, what you see is it looks like one file, but as you just saw, it was two files I opened. So you can't make these. There's no like merge into one, or there's no save as, combine or whatever. It just will save individually each file. So how can we get all of these files? Because for translators, it's very useful to have everything like Quark has. One file with the same layout but different languages, And the way you can do that is a book file. And let me show you how that works. What we're going to do in InDesign is go File, New, Book. And let's call that Book 1 to our desktop. What you get is this here panel. And the way you make a book is you can hit here, Add Files. Add documents. You can select, okay, say I want to add those two menu items in there. Click OK. You do have to save them again. So I'm just going to give them a slightly different name. And it's warning us there's missing fonts and whatnot. And it basically imports those files into this book here. And what you can do from there, you can save the book out, you can print the book, you can add more documents, you can remove documents. So if we save the book, and we quit out of the book, and we go back to our desktop, and we have the book file here, we open it up, we get this again, right? So that's a book file. You make individual chapters and all that. What you can do is you can click on any of these items, or you can select both, double click, and what you get is both items now active and open in InDesign. So by creating a book, you get the same sort of tabbed layouts that you have in QuarkXPress 9 or 10, but now you have it in InDesign. So it's a little bit of a extra step than Quark. But this is a solution for InDesign users, which particularly have used Q2ID to convert their Quark 9 or 10 files into InDesign, CC, CS6, even CS5.5, etc. They can use the book feature to tab everything together, have tab layouts. And then from there, you can do anything you want. You can output these files, you can print, etc. That's a quick tip of the day, how to get a tabbed layout-like feature in InDesign, just like Quark. by using the book feature, how to merge multiple InDesign files into one. If you need more information on Markzware's Q2ID to get your Quark files into Adobe InDesign, just go over to markzware.com/products/Q2ID, and there you get all kind of information on how you can do that. We also have other products you may be interested in as InDesign user, such as our PDF to InDesign, which will convert PDF files right into Adobe InDesign. Very, very useful. Thank you. David Dilling from Markzware, wishing you a fantastic day.